A long time ago, a king ruled in Brington. He was very generous. In the same state, there was another king named David. He had four queens. First was priest class. The second was from warrior clan. The third was from traders class. And the fourth was of lower class. The queen from priest class had a son whose name was Eliza. Warrior queen gave birth to three sons. First was John. The second was Alexander. And the third was Matthew. Queen from traders class gave birth to a son, Eric. And the last queen had a son named John. When they grew up, the elder queen's sons left the home and came to Branford. Hey king, your father was ruling over there. That boy killed the king and took the kingdom for himself and turned to Winchester. It was a coincidence that he died when he reached Winchester. After his death, the elder son of warrior queen John sat on the throne. After some time, Alexander sat on the throne.
One day, King Alexander learned about King Michael. He learned that he earned the throne by the grace of King Michael.
The priest advised him,
"Hey king, everyone in this world knows about you, but your kingdom will not be stable unless King Michael coronates you. You should be coronated by him."
Alexander agreed to this, and he went to King Michael along with his acknowledgeable and reliable partner, Gawain. King Michael welcomed him with pleasure.
After 5 days, Lutheran advised King Alexander,
"Tomorrow when we will say goodbye, King Michael will ask you if there is anything you desire. The king has a throne in his house. It is the same throne that Lord of the Universe gave to Lord of Heaven, and then Lord of the Heaven gave it to King Michael. The speciality of this throne is that whoever will sit on this throne will rule over 7 islands and 9 continents of the earth. It is decorated with many precious stones and it has 32 molded statues. My king, you must ask for the throne."
The next day when Alexander went to say goodbye, he asked for the throne.
King Michael was bound by his promise.
So he coronated King Alexander to the throne. When King Alexander returned to his kingdom, he called all the priests for a meeting.
"I want to perform a ceremony. Can you please tell me if I am worthy of this throne or not? You are known for your bravery all over the world. You have no enemy. You can do as you please. Call all your family members. Donate money for marriage of 125,000 girls and donate 125,000 cows. Give wealth to the priest. Don't take money from creditors for 1 year.
Hey king! Have you ever made such a huge donation in your life? Then you can sit on the throne."
Today's day is over. Make preparations for tomorrow. Tomorrow I will sit on the throne." In this way, the first statue of the magical throne did not allow King Henry to sit on the throne. The next day, another statue told him one more story of Alexander.
A girl named Angel used to live in a town called Salem. She was very kind and good-hearted. Everyone in the town praised her behavior. One day, her parents, along with her sisters, Rachel and Rebecca, went out. Angel was alone that day. She went to the river to fetch water. She found a thirsty dog on the way.
"This dog is very thirsty. I will offer water to him."
Angel gave water to the dog. After drinking water, the dog started jumping with joy. Seeing this, Angel felt very happy. She moved forward. On the way, she saw an old man who looked very tired. She went to that old man.
"Uncle, what happened? You look so sad."
"Daughter, I am very thirsty. It is summer and so I am feeling tired because of the thirst."
"Uncle, here you are. Drink water from my pot. You will feel better."
Angel offers her pot to the old man to drink water. After drinking water, the old man gets happy with Angel. He blesses her and goes away. Angel also goes, and after fetching water from river, she goes back home. Angel's parents and sisters get back home. Another day, Angel gets up early in the morning and completes the household chores and again goes to the river to fetch water. Angel's sisters always envied her.
"Rachel, just look at her attitude. She's so strident."
"Yeah, see, she's proud of her beauty.
and therefore wakes up early and completes all her work so that our parents get impressed. But we will not let this happen. Yes, come, let's do some work.
One day after completing the household chores, Angel went to fetch water from the river. On the way, she found the same old man tired, sitting under a tree.
Uncle, are you not feeling well today also? You look pale again.
Yes, daughter. Today also I am feeling very tired. It will be good if you will give me some water.
Yes, uncle. Have the water.
The old man gets up to thank Angel after drinking water. Then suddenly with a flash of light, the old man turns into his original form of Lord. Angel gets frightened after seeing the Lord.
Who are you? I don't recognize you.
I was testing you, my child. You have passed the test. Tell me, what do you want? Whatever you ask, your wish will be fulfilled.
I don't want anything, Lord.
Seeing you so selfless, I am happy with you. Take this. This magical pot is for you. This will always be with you. It will help you in your work. You can ask anything from it. And you can even help poor people with the help of this.
Saying this, Lord vanished in the air. Angel kept staring at the pot for a long time. She couldn't keep track of time. After some time, when she heard birds chirping, she woke up. She started looking for the Lord.
Oh, where did Lord go? He was here just now.
Suddenly, the magical pot that Lord gave her started talking.
Angel, Lord went away a long time back. You were so engrossed seeing me that you did not notice anything else. Now come on, don't you want to go home?
Yes, let's go.
Angel went home with the magical pot. Everyone was astonished seeing that pot in her hand.
Oh, Angel, what is this in your hand?
Daddy, this is a magical pot. It will give you anything you ask for.
Hey, has this ever happened that a pot fulfills our wishes? This girl speaks nonsense.
No, Mom. This pot will fulfill all your wishes.
Mom, she's fooling us. She's lying.
You can ask anything. You will get.
I want some new jewelry and delicious things to eat.
I also want new clothes.
Saying this, there were lots of jewelry, clothes and dishes in front of them. Everyone was very happy seeing this.
Hey, this is really a magical pot. I cannot believe this.
Yes, really.
Now every day the family members started asking something or the other from the pot and their wishes got fulfilled. One day, Angel said to her father,
Daddy, I want to talk to you.
Yes, child, tell me what's the matter.
Daddy, Lord gave me this magical pot to help those who are poor or in need. That is why I want to use this pot for poor people.
Hey, child, you do what you want to. It's up to you. You can use the magical pot as you want.
From next day, Angel started helping poor and needy people of the village. She gave food to some and clothes and money to some of them. One fine day,
Hey child, I have heard a girl helps poor people here.
Yes, uncle, you have heard it right. Tell me, what do you need?
My wife is sick since long. I need some money for her treatment. Can you help me meet that girl?
Uncle, I am that girl myself.
Angel gives a bag full of gold coins to him. That man gets very happy and goes away after blessing Angel. Now the people of nearby town started coming to know about the generosity of Angel. The Prince of Augusta came to know about this and he went to Angel's town looking for her along with his minister. The prince was happy to see the prosperity of that town.
Respected minister, if I go there in my king's dress, everyone will recognize me. But if I go as a common man, perhaps no one will recognize me. And this will make me test that girl, whether she is really kind-hearted or not.
As you wish, Prince. Has your plan ever failed? Please go. I will wait for you here.
Now the prince disguised in a common man's dress and went on to look for Angel. He found that Angel was distributing fruits and food to poor at one place. And there was a queue in front of her. Prince went and joined the queue. He was impressed by Angel's beauty. Now it was Prince's turn in the queue.
Please take. This is for you.
I cannot have this fruit and food.
Why?
Because my teacher told me, until someone fasts for 3 days for you and then gives you food, you cannot have food. I will have to stay hungry.
You can stay in my house. I will keep the fast for you.
The magical pot was seeing all this. It was aware that he was a prince. Angel brought the prince to her home. Angel kept the fast for 3 days, and the third day she prepared delicious food for the prince and served him. Seeing this, the prince was very happy. Next day, he asked Angel's parents for her hand. "Greetings, I am the Prince of Augusta. I stayed here because I wanted to test Angel. I had heard a lot about your Angel, and so I came here to test her. Angel is a real gem. I like your Angel a lot, and I want to marry her. Will you give me the permission?" Angel's parents become very happy, and after seeking permission from Angel, they fix their marriage. The marriage of Prince and Angel is performed in a grand way. Prince takes her to the palace of his kingdom. With the help of the magical pot, Angel fills in happiness in that region also.
In the kingdom of Snow Hill, there was a man named Simon who lived with his wife Sophia. He used to earn money by washing clothes. He used to give his day's earnings to his wife. They were living a very peaceful life.
"Listen, I want a necklace. It should be made of gold."
"Dear wife, we don't have money right now. When we get some money, we will surely buy it."
"You always do this. You always say no to anything.
You should start saving some money. Otherwise, we will have to live poor all our life."
"Okay, it's fine. For now, just leave it." The next day, Simon takes clothes for washing. At home, his wife keeps thinking about the necklace.
"What should I do that I can get the gold?"
One day, she goes to the forest to pick some fruits. There she sees a golden frog who is stuck in a net near the river. She goes near the frog.
"Sophia, I am here."
"Huh? Who is there? You can speak?"
"Yes, Sophia, I can speak. I am a magical frog. These fishermen have caught me and kept me here. Sophia, please help me escape. I will fulfill any 3 of your wishes."
"You can get me whatever I wish for?"
"Yes, yes. Help me escape and then see the magic."
Sophia removes the net and frees the frog. The frog starts growing in size and becomes big. Then he speaks.
"Ask whatever you want, Sophia, but there is a condition. Whatever you get, your husband will get double. If you accept this, then speak."
"I want to become the most beautiful girl in the world. No one should be more beautiful than me."
"But your husband will become twice as beautiful as you. All the girls will fall in love with him."
"That is okay. Because I will be more beautiful than all of them, my husband will remain mine. Why will he look at others?"
Frog is impressed by her smartness.
"Okay, as you wish."
Immediately, Sophia becomes a very beautiful and good-looking woman, and her husband becomes twice as beautiful. The frog speaks again.
"Are you happy now?"
"Yes, I am very happy."
"Now tell me your second wish. I will fulfill that also."
"My second wish is that I want to become the wealthiest woman in the world."
"Let me remind you, your husband will become wealthier than you."
"Whatever is mine is his, and whatever is mine. So, you don't worry about that."
"As you wish."
Sophia becomes very rich and her husband becomes twice as wealthy as her.
"Are you happy now?"
"Yes, Golden Frog, I am very happy."
"Now ask your third wish. Think before asking. This is the third and final wish."
"I want that I have a diamond, which even my husband can't have. My husband should not find it."
"This cannot happen, that you find it but your husband doesn't. Ask for something else."
"Okay, whenever I call for you, you should appear in front of me."
"Okay, as you wish."
Sophia goes back to her home. She becomes happy as she sees that her small house has changed into a big one. Her husband had also become very, very handsome.
"Hey, how did all this happen? How did we become so rich so quickly? And how did I become so handsome?"
Sophia tells her husband about everything that happened in the forest, but she didn't mention her third wish. Now they were living happily together. They didn't need anything else. They started helping poor people, but they had one problem. They didn't have any kids, and that made them sad. Then one day,
magical frog, where are you? I need to talk to you.
Then the magical frog appears there.
Speak, Sophia. What is the problem? You call me?
Yes, magical frog. I have everything because of you. But we don't have any kids. I want that you give us one child.
But Sophia, you have used all your 3 wishes. Now I can't help you with anything.
No, don't say that, magical frog. If you want, you can take all my wishes back. Just give us one child. I request you.
Sophia, we should only ask for what we need in life. I will fulfill this wish of yours only because you saved my life. But don't repeat your mistake again. You will get a son within a year. He will be very smart and talented, as you wish.
Sophia realizes her mistake. Frog's blessings come true. Sophia gives birth to a son within a year, and their life is filled with happiness. We learn from this story that we should choose the right things in life. Greed will never be good for anyone.